Global warming has been the excuse for the hysteria. But true science now shows that to be the greatest hoax ever perpetrated on humankind. So there's no need for these dire policies to cut back our carbon footprint by forcing us to lock away land and resources and live in high-density cracker boxes. We all want a clean environment. However, what we're objecting to here is not environmental protection, but the process that's being used in its name. There is nothing local or innocent or normal about it. Again, it starts as an international agenda created by ideological zealots working hand in hand through massive international gatherings sponsored through the United Nations. At those massive meetings, documents are carefully prepared for the signatures of leaders of every nation, including the United States. Once signed, the bureaucracies of our federal government use documents like Agenda 21 as a blueprint for legislation and regulations. To write that legislation, the bureaucrats work hand in hand with the same NGOs who wrote the UN documents. And then these UN-sanctioned NGOs like the Sierra Club and the Nature Conservancy team up with groups like ICLEI and the American Planning Association to apply pressure and make sure your city, local city councils and county supervisors toe the line. The resulting non-elected boards, councils, and regional governments appointed by an ecoligarchy answerable to no one is the perfect definition of a Soviet, a centrally controlled economy. And I assure you, we cannot restore our unique American Republic if our communities are little Soviets. Nor can we protect the environment if our economy is destroyed and free men and women are unable to make choices other than survival in a sustainableist tyranny.